Well, it looks like Princess Cruise Lines cannot catch a break. Two more of their cruise ships have now been denied port access. In today's episode, we're going to talk about what's going on. Along with that, we're going to talk about what Princess is doing to prevent the situation from happening again. Because honestly, I believe it's something that all cruises should consider doing if they want to keep this situation under control. Let's go ahead and get into it.
Let's go!
Hey, what's up guys? My name is Jay. Welcome to my channel, The Ship Life, where I talk about all things regarding cruise ships and the cruise ship industry. If this just happens to be your first time visiting my channel, or you've been watching my videos and you haven't already, make sure you guys sail over to that subscribe button and hit subscribe, along with the notification bell. That way you get notified whenever I post my new videos. So recently, the Regal and the Caribbean Princess were both denied access to dock in their home ports of Florida. This unfortunately was due to yet another health scare. All of this is in connection with the Grand Princess. That ship was denied access as well over off the coast of California and eventually was given permission to dock. Now, apparently what happened was these three ships were connected because of crew members. Now, if you guys don't know, me being a crew member, I've seen it happen plenty of times. It's a very, very normal thing, but usually when a cruise ship docks, there is also crew members getting off and on just like the passengers are. Usually they're either ending their contract or, like in this situation, they were being transferred. Unfortunately, after this whole situation that happened with the Grand Princess, you had crew members that were transferred to both ships, being the Regal and Caribbean. Now, unfortunately, after the crew and the ship was made aware of this, it was already too late. They were already out at sea. But once they were made aware of this, the crew members that were on the Grand Princess were quarantined on the Regal and Caribbean. And from there, they were tested in their next port. And, you know, I guess, you know, things ended up coming back negative and, you know, and they just kind of went from there. However, it was just a crazy situation because you guys know how crazy it's getting with the cruise ship industry right now. If there's any even a hint of flu-like symptoms or anybody getting sick, right? I believe that even the common cold may potentially cause a uprise on the ship, right? And just with the cruise ship industry alone, it's just that much of a serious situation right now. Everything's very sensitive. Now, after these situations were resolved and the crew members in question were tested, the home ports were then still kind of suspicious as to what's going on, and they wanted to confirm that everything was okay. So in that regard, they denied both cruise ships access to their home port to let the passengers off, and of course the potential crew members off as well. Now, once they did eventually get back to the home ports, because I believe they did yesterday, the cruise lines were very, very thorough in what their next move was, which was, of course, it started with the Regal Princess. They stopped their next cruise. They said they were gonna just stop and clean and make sure everything is as accommodating to the next passengers and as safe and as healthy as possible. Now, I believe from what I understand, both the Regal and Caribbean are now doing this, which I think is a very, very good idea. And I'll tell you guys why. Obviously, you guys know that this is a big deal amongst the cruise ship industry, and this whole situation started with Princess Cruise Lines. Everything that had to do with cruises and the sickness that's going around started on the Diamond Princess and eventually went on the Grand Princesses. Princess. And the biggest news that has been out lately so far with the cruise ship industry has been with Princess Cruise Lines. So I think it's only a fair thing to say that they have to take the highest measures possible to make sure the fear is kept down and that people are still willing to go on their ships. Otherwise, they lose money, of course, and you know, that's obviously not good for really anybody. Well, maybe the passengers, because there's a lot of good deals going around, which I'll talk about in another video. But anyway, guys, personally, I believe that as of right now, with everything going on, that is probably the best step that particularly Princess Cruise Lines can do right now, and it's something that I believe every cruise line should do right now. Now, I understand there are a lot of health regulations changing per cruise line, so I can't speculate what's going to happen, nor can I say what the regulations are for each individual cruise line, because whether it be Carnival, Royal Caribbean, P&O, everybody's doing things differently. But I think what Princess is doing right now is probably the right thing. Right, if there's a health scare or if there's any kind of sickness at all, I think the proper action to take, if there is a situation like that, call off the next cruise, give the people their money, do what you got to do, or maybe extend, stay in port another day and do all the proper cleaning that you need to do. I get that it's costly, guys. If you don't know that, to stay in a port, which is probably, I think, the one of the biggest expenses for cruises, to stay in a port, you're talking about hundreds of thousands of dollars, I think, per couple hours, right? I don't know the exact numbers, but it's expensive. But I think overall, that just may be the best bet, as opposed to taking a new batch of passengers out to sea only to find out that somebody is sick, because one person being sick alone is causing a huge, huge problem, and that's not good for anyone. So to every other cruise line out there, I don't think they're watching this video, but if they are, maybe you guys should follow the leadership, I guess you could say, of Princess Cruise Lines, because they're doing it right. Anyway, guys, this is a quick video. I just want to update you guys on what's going on. Like I said, this whole situation has been resolved so far, and the Princess cruise ships were able to eventually dock in their home ports. Let me know what you guys think in the comment sections below. Do you guys think that cruise lines should be a little bit more cautious, and if there is a situation, they should probably stay in port and make sure they do all the proper cleanings and checks, and maybe get the CDC, just have them on hand so they can actually make sure everything is as tidy as it should be, or you think they should just continue as scheduled so they can save a little bit of money? Let me know in the comments below, guys. I'm sorry if this video was kind of all over the place, but of course, guys, as always, support my channel. I'd appreciate it. Hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll come out with another video soon. Hope everybody is doing well. Stay safe out there. Remember that those masks do not work unless you're already sick. And yeah, you guys take it easy.